Hello everyone,
I'm Henry Lee. Now I'm going to paint a blue heron, a great blue heron. I saw it on the internet, the Autumn Dreams Birds Society, I think. I shared on my Facebook timeline, and my students saw this and requested me to do a painting demo. Here I am, grinding my ink with ink stick and ink stone. While thinking about my composition, I think the original picture is horizontal. I'm going to do it in vertical, so give me more room for the reflections. I like the posture or the catch of the fish is right at the moment. You know, I like this raised left leg. Try to help to get the fish, I think, but we don't see the claw. I think we. Yeah, I have to make it up if we don't do the grass, the weeds. I like the reflection, but it should be more on the downside, I think. Okay, I'm going to use some watercolor, see if I can get some blue. I have lots of blues here, so we mix cobalt and maybe some ultramarine. I just use this palette so you can see. Salute. This is the cobalt, I think. Yeah. Some opaque blue. To start with, it's like mineral blue in Chinese watercolor. This is a Western watercolor, the Holbein. Maybe a little bit to get that nice gray. I think we need to add some. I think I got some purple here. Yeah, that's what it looked like. Some crimson color into that. So it's a nice gray, but too much, maybe. Just add back some blue. Because this paper is very absorbent, it's unsized, I may need much more than regular watercolor. So. And I think it would be good to use a large brush. Let me just use a short handled brush. One of my favorite brush. I soak the brush before using, so the brush is flexible, and the hair will be integrate, you know, like hold together, not separate. Otherwise, it would be separate. So let's see if this one. I do this again with lots of water. This time, water. Right, some purple to give it warm, and some dark. I need this is a This is the shadow pool, I think. I'll mix some Ventec brown or something like that. It's very dark brown to get the dark blue. There we go. I'll do the light first. So we can start from the back. You hold the brush in the slant position, just one stroke for the back and put in the tail. It's like a hatchback here, and then make up another one for the you can use a little ink, this shoulder. To break in that wet into wet, and try to create some texture. I think it's better to blot it, so it's not going to blur too much. This is very important to stop bleeding with wasted paper, just the same kind of paper. You can also use that as a testing paper. This is a trick that you need to know. You can blot it from smearing. And I'm going to add the neck now with some warm color. Warm. Out of ultramarine. I think I got some here. Oops, that's enough. You don't have to blend it too much. So notice that it's kind of hard to do it in one stroke. I try. The painting is two-dimensional, so it's kind of hard to do the 3D in one stroke. It's pretty long leg. Leave the eye, just do the crown. There's a long like that. Oh, feather on top. Okay. There's some loose feather here. Like that. Speed is everything here. You cannot hesitate. Otherwise, you won't get it. Load a little bit more dark. And I need to do something in the under part of the body. The chest maybe is inside there, but we don't have to do much. Okay. And the thigh. You can start to outline things. This is the leg with the gravity. It's in a moment, kind of. Let me do this thigh, a little bit suggestion. One is like so. Okay. We change the brush into stiff hairbrush. It's a mountain horse brush. Or you can use any stiff brush like a the bear hairbrush, something like that. Oops. I don't know what's wrong with my iPad. was gonna sign off something here for me. Sorry. I think it's just a like a balancing move. Try to balance the movement of this. Okay, here's the detail part. I need to use a smaller brush and use dark ink to dot the eye. You can see the pupil is concentrated on the fish. So it's not in the middle. Exaggerate that. And nose. This is a very sharp weapon. Okay, let me do the fish. I think I will use the same color for the fish, just keeping it simple. Maybe a little bit more gray. The poor fish. Just a little warm color on the belly. Too much detail. The tail should be a little longer. And get some darks. Okay, that's it. Let me do a little bit background wash. You can use a larger brush. Well, I thought I could do more on the bottom, but end up leaving too little space for that imperfection, so it got to be on the this side. So let me just wash that with some watercolor. can use the little ink. Distinguish with the dark. Just let it blur into wet. Leave white and unprinted paper space. So this part, I think we should let it dry. But we can also avoid it. I'm not going to do much with the grass, but maybe a little hint would be good to have a little brown color. To actually, it's like action line to motion direction line. To increase the movement of the catch, everything should direct your eye to that fish. I use a little yellow ochre or raw amber. Okay, finally I'll wash the beak with a little orange yellow. And that's it. I will write a description. This is the same as you can orchid. That's why orchid is so basic. If you know how to organize orchid leaves, it's much easier. Very easy to do the reads here. Okay. Let me move the camera a little bit so you can see what I'm doing. Will say something like great catch or lunchtime. Okay, I'll think about something more poetic, maybe. And even I will write there or even on this side. I think it will be better on the corner or just a simple signature on the corners. Another corner would be fine. Okay. Thanks for watching and hope you enjoyed this video. I'll post the final result in my Facebook. Until next time, bye bye.